before today, so you? Yeah. How many rounds are you doing?
Not too sure, not a clue. We'll see.
It is
9 minute rounds. We'll see if he's got it in him. Dog out bounds.
Let's get in. Oh.
Johnny's sparring sessions, what are you as a coach looking to get out? Well, we've been on the verge of a world title.
Yeah, for Jack, obviously, it's just about keeping him active, keeping his eye in, keeping his range and distance. It's not nothing too physical, but I mean, more like Jack's a lot bigger than him physically. So be working on defensive stuff, you know, trying to obviously thinking about in the future Ramirez, that sort of Mexican walk forward style. He's going to have to be a little bit more active himself, letting his hand go, but at the same time he's still got to use the best part of his style, which is that really good defence, the way he makes people miss and then he makes them pay. So we're working on stuff like that, but like I say, it's nothing too serious at the minute. It's just about keeping him active and keeping his eye in, really.
There's nothing better than sparring, but you know, training really
for boxing. Well, that's it. Obviously, it's hard to keep motivated when you've not got an actual date to keep fighting. So sparring is one of them things where, as long as it's not too hard and too often, it's one of them things where it keeps you motivated and keeps you sharp and active, because there's nothing worse than just going to the gym eating the bags and, you know, to keep you fit and stuff like that. It just doesn't work. You know, it only works for a certain amount of time and then you just get bored of it and then you end up going up a boil, and that's not what I wanted to do.
We got a picture, Chris. After we got a picture.
The only way I can get Jack competitive round is to make him spar with someone who's bigger than him. Because when he spars with someone who's a 10 stone, unless like the top level, as soon as he starts getting nailed with stuff, they sort of back off. Whereas Jack, obviously, because Jack's so big, even though Jack's, you know, landing some decent shots, he doesn't mind keep coming and walking in, trying to walk him down. But it's the only way you're going to take him out of his comfort zone and get him to be able to go through them gears and feel that physicality. Because when he goes in with someone like Ramirez, he's going to have to cope with stuff like that, do you know what I mean? Yeah. Oh.
Got work, boys.
You can get a competitive round just by sparring with someone like you, Digger. Because everyone ends up fucking dead hesitant standing off. Good work, that. Right, ready?
How's that for you?
For me, it was good.
Great spar there, great work.
I've just come back from Tenerife, so it was a good wake up call, but I've anytime I get to fight with someone who's at a well higher level than me, I'll jump at the opportunities, you know what I mean? So I've picked a lot up from them there. Most of it when it bounced off my chin, but I still picked it up, you know what I mean?
Right, number one yeah. In the world. Can you tell that in there with certain little things that, you know?
Usually people who counter punch, I've got a good success with, because I've got a variety of shots and I've got a good variety of feints, but it was hard to, he was still counting me, you know what I mean, well, so you can see the level there.
Great experience for you, Pat. Yeah. You happy with that, Jack?
Really happy. Just getting the foot in the door now. Thanks to Jack and Alex having us down, it's good to get some rounds. Like Jack said, any sparring comes, make the most of the music, what you need it for. Jack's a good fighter. For me, it was about getting somebody like Ramirez. Jack's a busy fighter, work rate strong, come forward. It was good for me to be in them situations on the ropes, under pressure, find the gaps, find the escapes, and just keep practicing every day.
Jack's a little bit bigger than you as well, so
a big bastard.
He's strong as well, former MMA fighter. Do you feel like in there that's worth it? Do you like sparring the bigger fighters in preparation for
you've got to have these kind of spars, because push comes to shove on fight nights. I like sparring guys my weight, welterweight, but not being in them situations where these spars, even on the inside, with the MMA grips and, you know, just the physical strength of it, you need to be encountering all these situations.
Good Friday.
Good way to end the week. Well done, lads.
Nice one. Cheers,
Chris. One thing that I've realised about Jack Catterall is he's one of the most talented guys in the world. You know, we used him for Jack Flatley for the English title fight. We needed a southpaw. We spoke with Jamie. We said we'd use Jack Catterall, and I think it was the first spar that Jack had had. I'd let him have a little rest from his last fight, and he just really looked world class. You know, when you watch a world class fighter, you can feel it, you can see it, and it was the first round he started exploding, and I thought, fucking really good, Jack. And I remember when he was younger and he fought Chris Blinkhorn in the ABAs and Good Kids, and his progression has been brilliant, and he's an hard worker, and no one deserves it better, and it's nice to see, because he's a local lad, Charlie, and he looks good. I'm not sure about Ramirez, but I know that he's got Jamie Moore, who's a great with game plans, great coach, and Nigel, and then Jack himself is an impeccable fighter, so I can't see anyone beating Jack. Obviously, he's got to beat his A game at this level now, but he's very impressive, yeah.
Another day done. One day closer, so hopefully getting a fight. it's nice in there, isn't it? Got some good rounds. Busy gym.
What do you think of Jack? He's only had four fights.
But you can tell he's from a fighting background, and he's done the MMA. It was good. What you could tell, he on the inside, you could feel his like physical strength. Well, he's a big boy, anyway. He's a couple of weights above me, but you can tell he's got the strength there. But you can also, though, his punch selection, you could tell he was an MMA fighter, because they throw kind of like a different selection of punches, which were good, because you can practice different stuff then.